Hi, Yuri. So you got top 8 at a regional in Eindhoven this weekend.
Yeah.
Is there anything you want to say before the video?
I'm gonna miss my Paleozoic, so I play something else.
Do you think this deck is better than the Paleozoic?
I can't say it.
It's different.
It's different, but still traps. But the balance was perfect until we saw Eradicator Epidemic Virus.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I'm too afraid to play my favorite deck, Paleozoics.
So what are playing? What have you been playing this weekend?
Subterra.
Oh, Subterra. Nice.
Guru Control. How people are naming it.
All right. So, nice. Let's go into the deck profile.
So yeah. The new card of the set, Subterra Guru. Yeah, I'm not gonna explain everything, but
no.
this is like your main searcher of the deck and one of the control cards. And this gave the deck really a boost, so.
All right.
And it's a common, so this is like the cheapest card of your deck.
Awesome.
Yeah. Triple Fiendish. You have to play this at 3 because.
The mighty hand trap.
It's like, in theory, it's the best hand trap that there is actually,
game, yeah.
But it just has a restriction that you have to flip a face down, a Subterra face down.
It's so. Pretty much Archetype relevant.
it's an Archetype relevant, a reliable hand trap, but it's a Solemn Judgment for kind of. So
awesome.
Then I play double Subterra Nemesis Archer. Most people play this at 1, but I was testing this at 2. 2 is enough, but I think 1 is also good. 3 is too much.
Probably depends on the day.
Yeah. 1 Umastrix. This helps you deal with a lot of...
It banishes stuff when it's flipped, right?
It banishes monsters.
Yeah.
And the worst thing about this is that it mistimes when you flip a monster face down with the final battle, the trap.
Oh yeah.
So, yeah. And the best thing about this, with the final battle, this monster becomes 4700 attack.
Wow.
So so you can OTK with
that's
this.
That's a really good beater.
Yeah. And then a couple of hand traps, triple Ash Blossom, triple Effect Failure.
Okay.
I play Effect Failure because I don't have impermanences.
Right, so if you had impermanences, you would be playing impermanences.
Yeah. Because today at the team tournament, this got called by the grave, so I could coast over my opponent, so.
Yeah.
So, okay, triple Hidden City. Yeah.
That's awesome card.
Yeah, you need to play it. And then double Terraforming to search for your Hidden City.
Seems only logical.
Yeah. Then the money cards. It draws you, it's Pot of Greed. You don't.
Yeah, if you don't need your extra deck.
You never use your extra deck except for one of my side cards. And so it's a Pot of Greed in your deck, so. Triple Pot of Duality. You don't special that much.
Alright.
And one Cave Clash. You don't use this that much, but if you play against rogue decks that's really reliable under a normal summon, like for example my teammate Crusadia, Madolchi, decks that need to start off with a normal summon, you search this first turn with the Guru. So Guru is only a quick effect if there's another Subterra card on the field.
Oh yeah, so you need the Clash to use it as a quick effect.
Yeah. So, yeah. Then triple final battle for the traps. This card is broken. This card has 5 effects. It flips a monster face up, face down, boosts your attack, makes your monsters, that your monsters can be negated, and it sets itself face down.
That's actually really good.
This card is broken. And if you have multiples,
you can use
them all in the same turn.
Wow, that's crazy.
It's crazy, this card is broken. If this card ever becomes like the best deck, this card is gonna be banned. Or at 1 or something. Triple Solemn Strike and a Solemn Judgment.
Yeah, it stays a trap deck.
It's a trap deck. Triple Lost Wind. Lost Wind is insane. Like on the Subterra group, people were asking why Lost Wind? Thunder Dragons and the grind game against Sky Striker. This card is still, at this point, one of the best traps in this current format.
All right.
Except for like Evilly Matched or Flop Gates or something. And for talking about Flop Gates, I play Triple Ghost Match.
Yeah, it doesn't hurt your deck at all.
No, I only play like Earth Monsters. One of the other Floodgate that's really good in this deck, I'm still considering to play it next to this, is There Can Only Be One.
Yeah,
this,
of course.
I used to play There Can Only Be One, except of be next to this, but Ghost Match is also good.
All right.
This is the main deck.
Extra deck is pretty much irrelevant, I guess.
Yeah, but Triple Mrs. Radiance, one of this, two of this. Double of this.
The unicorn.
You can actually make this. You can never make this, never make this, never can make this. And then the only relevant cards in the extra deck are these two.
Oh, Super Polymerization.
Yeah, because I cite a Super Polymerization.
Yeah, all right, but why two of each then? Isn't one enough?
Because of the
oh,
pot.
Yeah, it's at random.
The pot banishes random.
Yeah.
This weekend at the regional, the winner box and the team tournament, I resolved this like 4 or 5 times. I always summoned this because of Thunder Dragons.
Awesome.
And it's so great. It's, you play all, you play this because this fuses two darks. So it's also good against Dark Warrior, Orcus and everything.
Yeah.
I play against 3 Orcus players this weekend.
Yeah.
The deck is actually insane.
It's a deck that's rising up in popularity.
Yeah. But that was extra deck, so yeah, I saw Super Polymerization, Orcus, Thunder Dragon and everything.
If you have the room, you have the room.
Yeah. Triple Prankotrops.
Awesome card.
Go seconds. And this won't be the Mexicans through Draco.
It also outs the rank up magic play that.
Yeah.
Because it's your first action and then you can change it to the rank up magic.
Nobody actually played that against me, but this won me at the original also against the Orcus player. I got pot of. Pot of extravagance and I draw these two.
Wow.
So that was actually insane.
That's crazy.
I side 2. Sword of Conceding Light.
Awesome card.
And, this deck struggles against the first turn Colossus if you don't open your Guru.
And
so
no Book of Eclipses then? Or
No, because I want to keep your face down.
Oh yeah, okay.
So yeah.
You aren't worried that they have a Titan that they can pop the.
No, it's an option, but you have to take the risk.
All right.
And then triple Heavy Stormblaster against Backrow decks together with the Backrotops. Triple evenly match.
All right.
It's evenly match. I don't think I need to explain this. For the regional, for the winner box, I played double Apocrypha and a Trap Trick. So I can set the Lost Winds, the Apocryphas and the Heavy Stormblaster.
All right.
And this was for the winner box in the regional.
It worked out pretty well.
They were great. And right. Today at the team tournament, I played
Triple Ghost Ogre. They were good as well.
Yeah, I cut this for this.
So basically, you can go both ways, whatever you like.
Yeah. If you're afraid of combo decks, I should play this.
All right.
And otherwise, this. But this was great. And this, I never resolved this.
It's actually fun giving people options, so.
Yeah, so I topped all 3 tournaments this weekend, so the deck's performing really well.
The deck is actually doing really well.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Thank you for the deck profile, Yuri. Is there anything else you want to say at the end?
Huge shout out to my team, OCC. Shout out to you for the deck profile. Today at the team tournament, so Jawad and Sebastian for playing with me.
Okay.
To Roy for driving.
Alright. Thanks for everything, Yuri. Hope to see you in the next video. Ciao.
Nope.